Friends, my topic is in global warming. My model shows how the causes and effects of global warming. The first cause is fossil fuels from the factories. The second is about the cars giving out carbon dioxide. And third is deforestation. This can lead to melting glaciers, which can cause ocean levels to rise. It can also lead to endangered species. My greenhouse gas emission for the past 1.5 decade, greenhouse gas emission has been polluting the atmosphere of Earth. The diagram shows how the greenhouse gas is getting warmer and sending toxic into the atmosphere. The causes and effects are that vehicles produce carbon emission from cars burning fossil fuels from factories and deforestation. We can stop global warming by producing electricity like solar panel, windmill, and hydropower. The organizations willing to help are WWF Worldwide Fund, NRDC, which stands for the Natural Resource Defense Council, and the Climate Change Group. Thank you.
Wastage of natural resources. My global context is globalization and sustainability. I picked this topic as I wanted to know how we are causing wastage of natural resources and how these actions are affecting us back. My inquiry question is, how does wastage of natural resources affect us as a species? These are the ETL skills I used. This is my poster. There are two quotes. I will like to share these. Quote number one, I don't want to protect the environment. I want to make an environment that doesn't need protecting, by Anonymous. Second quote, Earth provides enough to satisfy every man's need, but not every man's greed, by Mahatma Gandhi. We humans create many problems due to our needs. Here are some examples. Climate change, desertification, soil erosion, fewer crops, flooding, increased greenhouse gases, etc. I found out that overpopulation has led to the overconsumption of natural resources. According to the BP Statistical Review of World Energy in 2020, 84% of the world's energy consumptions are from fossil fuels. As we know, humans use and waste a lot of energy every year. Most of this energy comes from fossil fuels. Though now people have started using solar, hydropower, and wind energy to create electricity. We can use less water, turn off lights, recycle, use both sides of a paper, avoid single use of plastic, promote the idea of renewable resources. This is a summary of everything I talked about. This is my bibliography. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Anushree Maheshwari from grade 6A and today I will be presenting my presentation on energy transition. The global context I chose is globalization and sustainability. Here's why I chose this topic and these are the ETL skills which I will be demonstrating. Now let's get to know renewable energy and its forms. Renewable energy is energy generated by natural resources and can be renewed. A few examples of renewable energy sources are hydropower, wind energy, solar energy, biomass, geothermal energy, ocean energy, and hydrogen. What are a few advantages and disadvantages of using renewable energy? Disadvantages are it's eco-friendly, it is a reliable source of energy and leads to job creations. A few advantages are the electricity generation capacity is still not large enough, low efficiency levels, and takes a lot of space to install. The world heading towards energy transition. Over the past decades, renewables have changed our energy systems and have proven effective for many developed nations. But for the energy transition to be successful, it must occur globally, in both developed and developing countries alike. Here is a short video I found on 10 priorities for a successful energy transformation pathway. Here's a bit of research work I did. Are there any issues related to burning fossil fuels? Yes, there are a lot, but one of them is the chase fuels the crisis. The incident took place on 13 April 2022. Basically, scientists were getting arrested for protesting against the use of fossil fuels. They were also saying that we need to limit the use of fossil fuels to prevent the huge impact of climate change. Here are a few ways we can prevent the worst impact. And the fossil fuels shortage. The shortage had been caused by climate protests blocking major fuel depots. The gas prices have gone up, meaning some drivers have been filling their cars as much as they can before the prices can increase any further, which there is a very likely chance of. Here's a bit of evidence. And another video. Here's my bibliography. Thank you.
Hi everyone, I'm Anvita from 6A and I'll be explaining to you about war. War, state of conflict generally armed between two or more establishments. It is characterized by intentional violence on the large part of bodies of individual organized or trained for that purpose. Causes of war. The causes of war are almost endless. Wars have been fought in the name of religion, in self-defense to acquire territory or resources, as well as imperialism and nationalism. Victims of war, for example, in World War I, there were about 70 million deaths, whereas in World War II, there were about 15 million deaths. Victims of war can only be estimated. If there are only defined as those who died as a direct result of armed violence. But this would mean disregarding for those who died during a war from hunger, exposure or epidemics. Politics and economy. This world announces is not spending money alone. It is spending the hope of its children, the genius of scientists and the sweat of laborers. The following are the costs of war. Increased military expenditure and macroeconomic effects such as inflation and limitations for savings and investments. Environment. Damage caused by oil, chemical, landmines often takes a long time before it gets repaired. The environment is another innocent victim that gets caught in crossfire. I would like to conclude my thought by saying that war is the enemy of all human civilization. Nothing good can be achieved from it. It can never be glorified in any form. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Errol. I'm from grade 6A and my exhibition topic is Earth and Humans. This is my logo. For the global context, I chose globalization and sustainability. Environmental. Increasing population and economic development leads to water and air pollution, which leads to global warming, which leads to changing weather. If not controlled, our world will not be sustainable. Dirty water or air, unhealthy people, shortage of land and food for the world, losing animals and plant lives with more animals and lands to extinctions. Cultures. Globalization increases technology and communications, which reaches all people on a global basis. Positive impact. Technology can increase all people's awareness of the world around them. It can lead to better lives for people in rich and poor countries. Negative impact. But it can destabilize cultures. Young people may want to be like Koreans in the way they live their lives. Misunderstandings of uniqueness of individual cultures and people. This could end up losing cultures of the world forever. War and peace. Globalization increases the differences between cultures, economies, and where people may wish to live. Positive impact. Peace. Globalization leads to longer lives, more richness for the world, and can lead to peace. Negative impact. Globalizations can lead to decreases the stability of different countries and leaders. Ukraine and Russia as an example. Palestine and Israel as an example. Why did I choose this topic? I chose this topic because I think this is an interesting topic and a nice topic that I can do for my exhibition. And I also noticed that many things happen like war and peace, environmental activities, and more. What is the goal of my research? My goal of my research is to make other people understand and learn what I've learned from this exhibition. What did I learn? I learned that there are still war happening in other countries like Russia and Ukraine. Many plants and animals are close to extinct. Misunderstandings can lead to war. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Ashwin. I'm gonna talk about animal cruelty. How many animals are cruelly treated every year? Nearly 1 million animals are abused or killed in the United States each year, according to estimates. How many animals face animal cruelty? Every year, about 150 million animals, including mice, rats, dogs, cats, rabbits, and birds, are killed in laboratory tests for chemical, food, and cosmetic testing. Where are animals abused the most? Animals in Asia are among the world's most harmed, from bears being abducted and kept in cages for their bao, to dogs and cats being butchered in gruesome ways for their meat. What religion is the kindest to animals? Buddhism. Buddhism is known for practicing and promoting peace for both humans and non-human animals. What can be done to put an end to animal abuse? Toys, food, and blankets are all good options to donate. You may not be able to buy a pet, but merely donating allows the animals to feel loved. What type of animal mistreatment is the most common? The most common kind of animal cruelty is neglect. What is a proven fact about animal cruelty? Every minute, one animal gets abused in the United States. Nearly 10 million animals are harmed and killed each year. 97% of animal cruelty cases occurs on farms. Why does animal cruelty need to be stopped? Violence against animals has to be linked to a high likelihood to criminal violence and domestic abuse. This is my bibliography. Thank you.
Hello, I am Ayan Patnagar, and the topic for my exhibition is unemployment growth. I picked this topic because I found it really interesting and I wanted to find out more about it. This is my poster on unemployment growth. Okay, now let's get back to our inquiry question. And to understand that, we first need to see what is unemployment. Unemployment basically means when a person's actually searching for employment and still is unable to find work. Also, for this, you need to be actively looking for a job, not just never look for a job and then say you're unemployed. A man willing to work and unable to find work is perhaps the saddest sight that fortune's inequality exhibits under the sun, by Thomas Carlyle. How are people exploiting this? Well, some countries provide the most generous unemployment protection systems. In an article, I found that roughly 40% of workers stand to make more money unemployed than their former jobs. Especially lower wage earners who are concentrated in certain industries like retail, accommodation, food services, they might just leave their job And later, people may exploit this, and there might be no person who works in these industries, and unemployment will grow dramatically. How's this getting unfair? Well, like I said earlier, some countries provide the most generous unemployment protection systems, and some belong to medium-level type system. So here's the catchy part. Many countries don't even have this much. Unemployment protection schemes exist only in a few African countries. Did I even mention most African countries have a 30% unemployment rate? What shall we do? According to me, there shall be nothing like unemployment protection systems. But instead, if you're qualified enough and you're still not getting jobs, you shall be given a job from your government. For example, if you've gotten a doctorate degree, the government can issue you a job at the government hospital. So you'll even need to work for the money you get. What am I going to do? Well, I'm not really great at taking physical actions like doing a rally or those kind of stuff. But what I am good at is convincing people and communicating messages. So rather, I'm going to communicate this. This is going to be the action I will take. After all, every action matters. What were my methods of research were the internet. And finally, my bibliography. Thank you.
Water pollution, how it impacts the earth. What is water pollution? Water pollution is the contamination of water sources by substances which make the water unusable for drinking, cooking, cleaning, swimming, and other activities. Pollutants include chemicals, trash, bacteria, and parasites. All forms of pollution eventually make their way to water. My poster. Effects of water pollution. It kills aquatic plants and suffocates them. Contamination of the food chain. The deaders. Kills sea creatures. How can water pollution impact other living things? The plastic entering our water harms not only marine life, but also humanity. Plastic kills fish, birds, marine mammals, and sea turtles. And it also destroys habitats. How can we prevent water pollution? By throwing trash in the bin, wash your car on a grassy area, don't use plastic bags, reuse items, limit use of detergent and bleach, save water, use it wisely. Why did I choose this topic? I picked this topic because I feel like we need to raise awareness about water pollution. Here's my bibliography. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Gwen. I'm from 6A and I'm going to be doing a presentation about art for therapy. People do art therapy to reduce their stress, process their feelings, and manage their behavior. It helps people reflect on themselves. I chose this topic because it seemed like an interesting subject to talk about and I haven't seen it get much attention. What is art for therapy? A kind of therapy that integrates mental health and human services by using active art making, creative process, applied physiological theory, and human experience. Ways to do art therapy. Express your emotions with either doodling, coloring, or any type of art. Benefits you get from doing art therapy. Reduces stress and anxiety, helps you calm down, expresses your emotions through art. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Harman Hajani from 6A. The last I checked on Google, I'm the only Harman Hajani in this world. And just like each one of you watching, there's just one of you in this world. What does this mean? This means we are all different, with different names, cultures, religions, beliefs, and looks. Today, it is these differences that have brought us apart. The more we move apart, the more problems we will have. I believe that although we are all different, we will have one thing in common. We all share one home, Earth. If in spite of all of our differences, we come together, we can do wonders, not just for our generation, but for generations to come. But how could sports unite the world? Sports brings a sense of understanding and togetherness to everyone. For example, the SEA Games show a healthy mix of cooperation and teamwork. The Olympics shows union among the continents and meeting of athletes. Here are some real-life examples in unity in sports. World of Football stand to Barcelona Football Club raise awareness to stop war. Rival team, Liverpool Football Club, applaud in respect and solidarity for Ronaldo after his son passes away in childbirth. England football team take the knee to show respect for Black Lives Matter. In conclusion, I believe what the world needs now is to unite, as this will help us solve a lot of our problems. Sport is a great way to instill the sense of unity among people from all parts of this world. So the next time you participate in a sport, don't just think about winning, but look at it as taking a meaningful step to stay united in the name of humanity. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Yi Jen from 6A, and my exhibition topic is the ancient history behind war. This is my global context, my SOI, my key concept, and my ATL skills. Why I chose this topic? I chose this topic because I learned about this in my history subject, and I want to create an awareness about the cause of war and how it affects the world. Causes of war. Often, there are wars caused by one country's wish to take control of another country's wealth. Sometimes, countries need more land, so they take over other countries. Effects of war on people and environment. The people living in areas of war get hurt physically and mentally. Because of war, the harmful gases can damage trees and plants. How we can stop war? We can make signs and put them around the city. Citizens can make petitions and share them on social media and other platforms. Facts about war. How were wars? Most wars in current times use guns, bombs, but in ancient times, the wars used horses, swords, shields, and cannons. This is my brochure. What is my goal? My goal is that I want to create awareness about the cause of war and how it affects the world. Most of my research was primary and some was secondary. My methods and sources of research were I read books, the world history, and I watched YouTube videos of war. My integration with any other subject. My integration was with English. While working on my project, I learned new vocabulary, so I integrated with my topic with English. Here are some of my world working pictures. This is my bibliography. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Hiro, and today I'm going to be talking about world hunger. What is world hunger? World hunger indicates the amounts of the human population who don't get enough food to eat. Some countries suffer from hunger, but one in particular is Africa. Some countries in Africa, for example, that are suffering from hunger are Sudan, Somalia, Ethiopia, Kenya, and Niger. There can be 10 ways to stop world hunger: food, credit, food donations, transitioning, modern farming, education, social change, government intervention, empowering women, and teaching birth control. Here is an example of starving children in Africa. They are skinny to the bone because they don't have enough food to eat or enough water. We can help world hunger by food over trade, curtail companies, rebound riches, rights to land, fair trade, free food, balance with nature, and incentivize good food. Here is a picture of happy children in Africa because they get food to eat, they can drink, and lots more. Thank you for listening to my PowerPoint.
Hello everyone, my name is Hiran Mawani, and today I will be talking about how does ocean pollution affect the environment. Ocean pollution is when we humans throw trash into the land, water, and even air. Today I will be talking about ocean pollution affecting the environment, like humans, animals, and plants. We all know that ocean pollution affects the marine life, but did you know it also affects the environment? It affects the animals, plants, and even us. First, I will be telling you how does it affect us. Ocean water is used to make drinking water. The process where it becomes clean is called water purification, and people buy it to drink. But there are people there who can't afford water, so they go to the ocean to drink it. But when the ocean is polluted, it might give them a lot of sickness, like dementia and amnesia. Ocean pollution affects animals too, especially the sea animals. They mistake the trash for food and eat them, and it affects the land animals also because they drink water from the river or the ocean, and if the water is polluted, it can get them really sick. Animals also bathe in the water, and the water is contaminated with so many germs and chemicals, so they can also get sick from that. It affects plants too, because plants need clean water, sunlight, and roots to grow. But if the water is dirty, then it cannot grow. It can cause an explosion to the other plants who are still growing. The countries with the most pollution is Africa, India, Indonesia, and China. Of course, there are ocean pollution everywhere, but these are the top countries which have the most of them. There are a lot of solutions to this, like stop polluting, create awareness, help people that do not have a roof over their head, start donating, grow more plants. Thank you.
I am Justin. I am presenting my exhibition poster about the topic gender equality. And my inquiry question is, can gender equality be achieved and how? First, we need to know what gender equality is. Gender equality is the state in which rights, opportunities, and treatment is the same for both male and female. How can gender equality be practiced in the workplace? Gender equality can be achieved in the workplace if the employers and management have an open-minded policy. They can easily do this by giving their employees equal salary based on their performance and not their gender. Unfortunately, though, women get pregnant, and when they get pregnant, they start to not feel well and have to take what's called a maternity leave. A maternity leave is a temporary period of absence from the workplace for pregnant women or women who just gave birth. Since men don't get pregnant, they don't get maternity leaves or days off, meaning we cannot have perfect gender equality because of our biological differences in the workplace. How can we promote gender equality in our lives? We can promote gender equality by 1. Talking and listening to females. This is also a reason we have not achieved gender equality, because women's and girls' voices are often excluded from global and national decision making. Adults can also share the household chores, because all adults living in the same home should be responsible for them, and also because women do the most of the time. We can also vote for female candidates. In conclusion, gender equality can be practiced in some areas, but we cannot have perfect gender equality because of the ways our bodies are built. But we can still promote gender equality in our lives. Thank you.
Cybersecurity by Kaya Ashwalayan. This is my logo and why I chose it. I chose this logo specifically as it showed the name of my topic and it has a simple design. The design has many wires all connected to one single area and its shape as a shield. I made my logo this way as cyber is another word for online and the wires represent that, while the shape is in a shield as it represents the safety and security needed online. What is cybersecurity? Cybersecurity is the practice of defending computers, servers, mobile devices, electronic systems, networks, and data from malicious attacks. It's also known as information technology security or electronic information security. The term applies in a variety of contexts, from businesses to mobile computing, and can be divided into a few common categories. Why is cybersecurity so important? Cybersecurity is very important in our lives, especially now in these trying times. We cannot meet our friends or even go outside, and so we're always on the internet. There are tons of social media platforms where we may spend most of our time or all of it, and these social media platforms are kind of harmless. But it's the people on these platforms that make it extremely dangerous. Nowadays, online, it has become very easy to impersonate someone else or even act like someone else. Platforms like Discord, Twitter, and Instagram make it easier for you to get catfished or tricked into telling someone your personal information, such as your phone number, address, credit card number, or more. This makes it easier for people to target you, and this is also how many murder cases begin with. How do I prevent myself from getting hacked? You can prevent yourself from getting hacked by not giving up personal information easily. And when you meet someone online, to first find out who they are. If you don't know who this person is, it could be very dangerous for you and your loved ones, as that person may be someone extremely dangerous. Some website might ask you to use cookies, which are pieces of code that, if used maliciously, can be used to take information from you. One trick to find out if a website is safe or not is by checking the link. If the link starts with HTTPS, it is safe. Otherwise, it's not. Using applications like NordVPN can also prevent and lower your chances of getting hacked. What apps can I use to prevent being hacked? There are many apps available on the internet, such as NordVPN. They help in protecting your entire device and letting you know whether or not if the website you're going to or app you're downloading is safe. They make sure you use the base minimum of cookies in order to decrease your chances of being hacked as well. Having different and odd passwords is also a hassle, and by using the same passwords, hackers would be able to access all your accounts and private information. Apps like Dashlane, Google Passwords keep your passwords with their email in a secure area, can only be accessed by you, by their Face ID, fingerprints, or another password. What should I do if I get hacked? The first thing you should do when you get hacked is to change all your passwords, including the one that's been hacked. Or if you have too many accounts, change your most important ones, like the one to your Gmail account. If you don't change your passwords in time, the person who was hacked have already accessed your information and you would be in certain danger. This is my bibliography. Thank you.
大家好。 我的名字是Erin Cole， 我的exhibition topic是性别并等， 这是我的重心，西乡和插唇线女， 这是我的标志。 我为什么选择这个话题？ 因为尽管取得了很大进展， 妇女和女孩仍然面临70， 女性复选，女性是可以通过自己的选择来控制自己的生活。什么是性别平等？性别平等是指所有性别的人都享有平等的权利、责任和智慧。我们都 注意到并顶到的某些性 是性。为什么性别平等如此重要？因为过于50年的自己正占有一般归于女孩或的更的教机会。这是关于为什么赋予女孩和妇女管理如此重要。我们如何赋予女妇女和女孩管理？我们可以赞助一个女孩和借书中魂。
Hello everyone, my name is Manit Bharangi. I am from class 6A. My topic is bird flight pattern. Global context. My global context is scientific and technical advance, innovation. The reason I have chosen the global context of scientific and technical innovation is because by learning the bird flight pattern, we can build a technical device that can use the bird flight pattern that to allow us humans to fly too. Why I chose this topic? I chose this topic because I love birds and not a lot. And not only that, but I want humans to be able to fly one day just like birds so we can make much faster transportation. My inquiry question. The question I investigated is how do different types of birds fly? ATL skills. The ATL skills I will demonstrate while working are critical thinking and reflection. Research. The research I did in my exhibition are about how birds fly. I used videos of birds flying online, then I researched about the flight pattern of the bird. Then I researched about many articles about bird flight patterns. My findings. I found out that there are many common bird flight patterns in birds, but they usually are different a little bit. The flight patterns include direct, undulating, flap and glide, moth-like, and static soaring. I found out that birds fly by blowing wind down. It creates enough lift for gravity not to pull them down back to the ground. The goal of my research. The goal of my research was to investigate how birds fly. Have I achieved this goal? Yes, in my opinion, I think I have achieved my goal by doing my research to learn about how birds fly and showing it to you guys. This is my bibliography. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Mithan Chubey and I'm from grade 60. Today, I'm going to presentate about dancing and world harmony. Different types of dances across the globe. Ballet, ballroom, contemporary, hip-hop and jazz. Types of dances that were created in countries. Ballet. The history of ballet begins around 1500 in Italy. Ballroom was created in Augsburg, Germany, where dancers moved together so closely that their faces touched. Contemporary, from its origins in Europe and America. Hip-hop. Hip-hop dance began during the late 1960s and early 1970s. Jazz. Jazz dance developed from the both 19th and 20th century stage. Dance and traditional black social dances and their white ballroom offshoots. Relation between dancing and cultures. Cultural dance is really important. This is our way to tell other people on what are the things that they need to know about our culture. Michael Jackson. Michael Jackson was one of the famous dancers we all knew. His songs made people love it. One of his famous songs of humanity was Human Nature, They Don't Care About Us, an Earth Song. Sadly, he died on June 25th, 2009. Why did I choose this topic? I've chosen this topic because I've seen people express their feelings in dance, and it's a good idea to talk about how people express their dance in their culture. Why did I research? I have researched about types of dances, dances about people who dance, and about the culture of the dance. And here's my dance about Heal the World by Michael Jackson.
There's a place in your heart, and I know that it is love. A place much brighter than tomorrow. And if you really try, you'll find there's no need to cry. This place, you feel there's no hurt or sorrow. There are ways to get there if you care enough for the living.
Hello everyone, I'm Myra Jaiswal from 6A and this is my exhibition presentation. My topic is animal testing and this is a logo I made myself which says say no to animal testing and symbolizes care. My global context is fairness and development because animals have right to and testing has to be fair. I chose this topic because I feel like it needs more attention. Animals don't have a voice, but we do. And it's time we use it to help other living beings. Are there pros of animal testing? My answer, yes. Sometimes there are. They can be used to make life-saving medicines, which can save many lives. It's even better if it's not very harmful for the animals. This is my poster. What ADL skills will I be working on? I'll be working on interaction, critical thinking, and language. My research. This is my research and these are the main things. What is animal testing? Examples of animal testing? What animals are normally used for testing and why are they used for testing? My goal was to make people aware of this topic about animal testing so people can think and act in favor of these poor little living beings. These are my method and sources of research. This is a poem I wrote called Silent Pain. I wrote this poem to express the pain of animals through just a few paragraphs. I feel like a poem will help make the audience understand better. What did I learn? I learned how to communicate, advertise, and I learned more about testing. The impact of the research. The impact of the research on the presentation is good. It makes the information more suitable for the presentation. And what is a presentation without research? Conclusion. I feel like by the end of this PPT, the audience should be concerned about testing and should take action.
Is it really that important? Is it really that important to put little creatures' lives in danger for beauty? Is it important to test, inject, poison poor little animals in the name of beauty? Do you think it's gone a bit too far? Imagine, guinea pigs, little rabbits, dogs, rodents, and more losing their life if a project went wrong. And they do all that just so a woman can have a suitable, reasonable foundation or lipstick? The little animals can't do anything about it, but we can. Animals have feelings, a heart, and little families they care for. Poor little animals don't even say a word because they can't. The pain they're suffering is deeper than ever. It goes to the extent that they can't even walk. They faint. Animals are not test subjects, and it's time we realize that. Say no to animal testing. Speak up for them. Thank you.
Good morning, teachers and parents. My name is Nolan Thang, and today I'm going to talk about my exhibition, Volcanic Eruption. What is volcanic eruption and how do they happen? volcanic eruption occurs when the magma is released. They can be calm or they can be even explosive. Effusive eruption produces lava flows down. On the other hand, eruptions produce ash. The rock inside the planet we live on can melt to form magma. This magma is lighter than the other rocks, so the magma rises up. And if it rises up, we get a volcanic eruption. What are the positive and negative effects of volcanic eruption? The negative effects are loss of habitat for the animals. When there is a volcanic eruption happening, the heat from the volcano and the hot lava causes a destruction to their natural habitat near them, and it could also kill the species by the lava. Air pollution. Whenever you see a volcanic eruption, there is a smoke. In that smoke, it's filled with large amount of carbon dioxide, nitrogen, ash, etc. When they are released, humans and animals cannot breathe properly as there is a small quantity of oxygen in the atmosphere. The positive effects are increases the soil fertility. When there is a volcanic eruption, a lot of ashes are pushed into the atmosphere. The ashes will finally go down and tremendously improve the soil around the area. Source of energy. Volcanoes can create geothermal energy in areas where magma lies close to the surface and can be found near the volcano. Thank you.
At labor. Why did I choose this topic? I chose this topic so that I can raise awareness about child labor. Child labor is not a common thing to see, but there are still lots of people doing child labor. What is child labor? Child labor refers to the exploitation of children through any form of work that deprives children of their childhood, interferes with their ability to attend regular school, and is mentally, physically, socially, and morally harmful. My poster on child labor. How many children are in child labor? The number of children in child labor has risen to 160 million worldwide, an increase of 8.4 million children. The causes of child labor and how to stop child labor. Methods and sources of research. I only used Google since Google had many different types of information about child labor. These are kids from Pakistan doing child labor. My findings. What did I learn? I learned that during the COVID-19 pandemic, more children had to experience child labor because of most people losing jobs. How can we help and stop child labor? Increase more access to education, provide support for children, improve economic growth, engage with the Sustainable Development Goals. What can I do to improve my product? I can research more so that my product will be more informative. I shall put less words and more pictures so that my audience will not get bored. This is my bibliography. Thank you.